Good to have you with us. You're watching Nation Now with me, Avni Raja, and our focus continues to be coronavirus, all the steps that are being taken by the country, by India, to battle and to stop the spread of this virus, and most importantly, to answer all of your questions and everything that we can with our experts who will be joining us today. Well, India has intensified measures to contain the spread of the virus at this point in time, both at the center and the state levels. Several steps have been taken. The big focus in all of these steps is that of social distancing. But there is still a lot of confusion that surrounds the coronavirus and that still persists, especially given the fact that there is still so much that we don't know about the virus. So what we're going to do on the show today is attempt to answer some of these big questions and attempt to clarify all the confusion, or at least some of the confusion that all of you may have. We'll have our experts as well. But before I introduce them, let me just take you through what are the questions that we're going to try and get some clarity on. First of all, who is it that needs to get tested? Remember, just because you have a symptom doesn't mean you automatically need to go and get tested for coronavirus. We'll clarify that for you. The next question, whether one should get tested if you have symptoms but no travel or contact history. Question number three, is complete self-isolation recommended if I'm healthy? Remember, social distancing is what is being propagated, encouraged, urged by all at the center, state levels, all experts. But what do you need to do? What is social distancing? What is isolation? When should that happen? Next question, how is a coronavirus patient actually treated? So we know that there is no cure for coronavirus right now. The vaccine for the virus is still months or maybe more than a year down the road. Right now, patients are being treated symptomatically. So what exactly is the steps? What needs to be done? What are the kind of medicines that are being used? Those are the details that we are going to try and answer. And next, of course, how long did the virus last on surfaces? Now, this again is important because the virus is transmitted through the touch is one way the virus is transmitted. So if we're talking about how long does the virus last on surfaces, this is again something that needs some clarity. Lastly, everybody is talking about the various stages of the way the virus spreads, and there are four stages that we know of, and the way we've seen countries such as Italy, such as China, which are in the thick of it right now, have been experiencing. So where is India currently, and what really are these four stages? So now these are some of the questions that we are going to try and get answers to today. Let me welcome my guests. We've got Dr. Rai, former General Secretary of IMA, who joins us, Indira Behara, Public Health Specialist, and we've got Dr. Vijay Hadda, Assistant Professor, Pulmonary Medicine from AIIMS in Delhi. Thank you all of you so much for joining us on this show today. So like I pointed out, we're going to try and sort of demystify some of these questions considering the fact that there is so much confusion still. So let me start with the first, one of the most basic questions that, you know, we're talking about here, which is, who is it that needs to get tested? So let me come to Dr. Vijay Hadda first. Dr. Vijay, if you can just take our viewers through this particular question.
This is a very important question because and many times we are getting requests from our colleagues, the friends, that they are having some kind of symptoms in the form of cough, maybe some sneezing, maybe fever. Any kind of these features are having, they are thinking that they are suffering from coronavirus and they want it get tested. But I want to explain it, or I want to clarify it, that everybody who is having these kind of symptoms are not required to be tested for coronavirus. Okay, the government of India have clearly defined the strategy who should be tested for coronavirus infection. So those patients who have recently either travel to the countries where this disease is epidemic, or those person who have come into contact with the known case of coronavirus infected person. Okay, if these conditions are not fulfilled, then testing for coronavirus is not recommended. So this one need to be kept in mind.
Okay. All right. Dr. Rai, you know, coming to you here, this is, of course, so essentially what we're saying is that unless and until you have either some history of travel to a place where coronavirus has hit hard, or you have come into contact or possibly could have come into contact with somebody who is showing symptoms of coronavirus, you don't need to get tested. But the other question I have here is the fact that, you know, how do you decipher that? Because the symptoms don't typically show up for at least a couple of weeks. So how do you know that that somebody who you possibly met is developed symptoms only later, and hence you should then be worried?
You know, if somebody has come in contact with the person who has been diagnosed positive coronavirus, definitely he should keep himself, first of all, in abundance, and he should keep himself in quarantine. That is the first thing they should do. And second thing is, unnecessarily, one should not be panicky if he is sneezing or he is coughing. That is not the, because this is the time when normal flu always comes. Until and unless you are not in contact with the positive patient, or somebody has come from the country to whom you have met as a friend, or you yourself has traveled to the country where this epidemic is there. Otherwise, there is nothing to worry. Your personal hygiene should be maintained thoroughly. Wash your hands, keep yourself away from the crowd. Don't sneeze in the public. Discourage the person who are sneezing on the road, give them tissue paper, teach them. This is the best way. Otherwise, if a small person is sneezing or coughing, if we keep on going to the hospital, what condition will become? Because the flu in one family, once the normal flu comes, all the family gets suffer. So I think until unless you are not in contact with the person, or you have not traveled to the country, or you have not met to the person who has come from the other country, there is nothing to worry.
Okay. All right. Let me, in fact, now go across to Indira Behara as well. Indira Behara, you know, what we are seeing now, both at the center and the state level, the fact that social distancing is being given a lot of importance right now. But at the same time, what we're also seeing is that it's not being done at a broad level. It's being done quite selectively in several states as well. What would you like to explain to us about the importance of social distancing at a time like this? What sort of is okay and what should definitely be avoided?
So I think it's important to understand what social distancing means, like you said, you know, being aware of, I think the coronavirus, the COVID-19 situation around the world has done a good job of, you know, making us understand where we stand in terms of pandemic preparedness, and as well become a little more aware as citizens of what it means to be to follow hygiene practices, cough etiquettes. Social distancing has become the big new phrase because it requires people to make sure that they are not going out in areas which, you know, with large crowds, with, you know, coming in contact with people who might be sick, which means, you know, you maintain a 6-foot distance between people, practice hand hygiene, you know, wash your hands properly with soap and water. That's also enough, really, for a good 20 seconds. Make sure if you have a cough or cold, and these should be followed, you know, no matter what infection you might have. Cover your mouth and nose when you cough and sneeze. If you're unwell, just, you know, make sure you take time off. And in this particular scenario, I think it's valuable for employers also to suggest these practices to their employees to make sure that non-essential travel is avoided. Because at this time, thankfully in India, we aren't seeing community transmission. And of course, the ICMR will continue to do random tests to make sure that, you know, to follow that trend. But in countries, as you may have seen around the world, where they are finding cases of community transmission, the best way to make sure that people, you know, don't get a highly infectious or virulent virus is that they keep a distance from each other. It's very important, I think, at this stage for our And they've been doing a very good job of it, I have to say. Our political leaders to be on the same page, first of all, perhaps, you know, there should be a standard set of guidelines according to categories of states for the kind of social distancing advisories and other public health advisories that they are issuing. You know, public leaders should come out and explain that allay people's fears, but also explain what they should be doing at this point in time to protect themselves and to make sure that they don't carry any infection, be it you know, the novel coronavirus or the seasonal flu or anything else, really. I mean, we're a country with a large population and, you know, very high population density as well. So we things can carry.
Right. Yes, absolutely. In fact, Dr. Vijay, you know, just taking that point forward, I mean, we understand that when we say social distancing, mass gatherings, you don't go anywhere where there are a huge number of people. So those parts are sort of easy to understand. But when we talk about other things, like do you stop completely meeting, you know, going to somebody's house, for example, going grocery shopping, or, you know, not all places, workplaces have, it's not a blanket work from home policy in several workplaces. So people still have to go to work. So whether to take a cab, you know, so those are a lot of questions that still are there that are creating a lot of confusion as well. What would be your advice?
So, as has already been told, this is basically social distancing is totally different. Okay, but if some things which needs to be carry on, like life is not like corona only. We have to continue our daily activities. Suppose somebody is going for job, he cannot leave without job. They should go, and they should follow all the personal hygienic techniques or cough etiquettes, the sneezing etiquettes. They should follow all that, hand hygiene. These are probably more important steps. And yes, social distancing is one step which can be taken. But the day-to-day activities, just I have told you, they should be continued like same. They cannot be, because life cannot stop here. So to me, social distancing means you can avoid the things which can be avoided, like if you can avoid going to movie, that can be easily avoided. Similarly, if you want to organize a party, or you want to organize a conference, or you want to organize some workshop, these activities can be delayed or they can be postponed. So these things are okay. But suppose I am a doctor, I want to go to hospital, I need to go to hospital. Similarly, there are other professions also where people are going daily to their jobs. So they need to go, but simultaneously they have to take care of themselves, and for that the personal hygiene, especially the hand hygiene, cough etiquettes, and then sneezing etiquettes, if they follow these things, then they can help a lot to themselves as well as the society in large.
Okay. Dr. Rai, if you would like to also come in here with any specific advice that you may have as far as this entire social distancing is concerned, and how it actually needs to be practiced, what can perhaps be excluded, but what should definitely be avoided?
I fully agree with the Dr. Saab, because unless it is not necessary to go out or go to other places, you should avoid it. But there definitely the persons whose job is such where he has to go to the hospital, at least we cannot say that we are not coming to the hospital, let the patient suffer. It's not possible. The only thing is we should stick to the norms which has been laid down to keep ourselves healthy. And by keeping ourselves healthy, we are going to keep others also healthy. And somebody, if by the way, cough is coming, it becomes my duty. Immediately, I should put some anki or some tissue paper in front of the nose, sneeze it, and I should throw that tissue paper in a nice place where it should not get out of that dustbin. Otherwise, it will spoil the others also. Second thing is, if somebody is sneezing, it becomes the duty of me also and others also. We should keep a distance of more than 4 feet, 4 to 4.5 feet. Because this droplet can travel up to the range of 3 and 3.5 feet. So it's better if we keep ourselves away. Now the lot of controversy has started, which I want to tell to my all the citizens here. The mask is out of the shelf, which is creating a lot of panic in the society. mask is needed only to the two persons. One person who is suffering from this COVID-19, he should definitely use the mask so that he will not spread the infection to others. And second thing, the person who should use the mask is doctor or the paramedical staff, because they are, every time they are coming in contact with the patient, they have to use it. Otherwise, other person they don't need the mask. You know what has happened in the market? Mask is not available at all. Sanitizers are not available in the park. And mentality of our people, I'm sorry to say, they have started giving furious, adulterated, below standard sanitizer in the market. Fake factories has come up. And such person should be punished very severely. Those people who are playing with the life of the citizen, they should be punished. They should not be spared at all. And that is the only thing, you know, I will appreciate the step taken by the government of India and the health ministry, and also to the state governments. Otherwise, this would have become a very, very troublesome period for the country. Now you can see, in the month of February when we started, there were only few cases. And today, also I'm telling about today, there are only 110 or 112 cases.
Right.
And as far as Italy is concerned, in Italy on 30th January, there were two cases. And on 2nd February, 21st February, there were two cases. On 22nd, it became four cases. And 23rd, it became 40 cases. And now it has gone to more than 20,000.
Yes.
Doubling period. What we call the doubling period is, if the doubling period is very prolonged, we are safe. If doubling period is very short, we are not safe.
Right.
Now,
right.
Country is passing through the stage of one and second stage we have passed.
Yes.
Now we are in third stage. At present, community contact is to be avoided. We should not allow the persons to get collected at one place. This
All
is
right.
the precaution I want to say to everybody. We
All
can
right.
fight with the corona.
Okay.
That is not a problem.
All right. Indira Behara, you know, coming back to you, just taking that point forward, you know, we're talking about, of course, we're seeing these four stages that several of the other countries who have been hit badly are have been experiencing. If you can just take us through what that actually means. And for India right now, we have seen a sudden spike in cases in the last week or so, but still it is not very bad right now. Where are we?
So when you're talking about the stages, I think you're probably referring to the WHO pandemic
Yes.
stages. And when our officials are talking about India being in stage three, it means basically at this time, you know, there is stage one where there's, you know, no evidence of it, you know, virus having transmitted from, you know, zoonotic to human beings, and then you look at stage two. In stage three, there is no evidence of, basically community transmission, okay? And that's where we stand at this point in time. Stage four, which is where many other countries are, talks about basically the fact that community transmission has been verified, and it has actually happened, and they've got evidence for it. I think it's very important, since we were having the conversation about what we can do to prevent progression. I think our health systems, our epidemiology teams, ICMR, are doing a very good job. What we as individuals, as groups, as a community can do is focus on how we can avoid non-essential contact. And so, like I said before, I think if it is not essential, for example, to travel, right, then, you know, perhaps companies can start look at avoiding it. We live in a modern age, you know, digital age, where a lot of things can happen over video conferencing and phones. And so where organizations can take a stand and say it's okay if people work from home as long as they're getting their jobs done and they're able to communicate. And I recognize it's not possible for all professions, but where it's possible, you know, in large startups or, you know, more digitally progressive firms and in service industry, you know, maybe companies should take a stand on that and encourage people to just stay at home, do their work from home. And of course, like I said before, you know, the government can continue to, and all public leaders should be talking in one voice when they talk about what citizens should do to avoid, large public gatherings, discourage people from perhaps, having these community seances and all-night songs of, telling the coronavirus to go away, because that's not helpful. You're getting too many people into one place. And even if it's not the coronavirus, any other infection can spread over there. So right. We're at a stage where we can still control things, and it's important to act aggressively and preemptively.
Yes, absolutely. Dr. Vijay, another very important question that I want to come to you about is how long does the virus actually last on surfaces? Because once again, there are so many questions, because the fact that this virus takes a few weeks or, in a lot of time to actually show up in the form of symptoms, how it is actually transmitted, there is that fear that something that I've touched, whether it's the door of a car handle, a door handle, if somebody else has touched that same thing even a week ago, it might still have the virus on it.
Actually, this is another fear, or you can say some kind of a myth, which is circulating in the social media, that it can stay for very, very long time, although we have very little data to say that what exactly is the period for which the virus can be active on the surfaces. But it is considered that it can easily survive for a few hours, maybe 3 to 4 hours.
Okay.
But in laboratory studies, it has been shown that it can survive even for 3 to 4 days. There are studies. But we have to think in a way that laboratory studies needs to be taken with pinch of salt, because they are done in very controlled environment kind of thing. And when it comes to the reality, the situation may be totally different. Okay. But one should understand that whenever this virus comes into contact with the surface, that is also a potential source of transmission of infection to others. So that should be kept also in mind. And if somebody is thinking that this surface might be infected or may be contaminated with virus, irrespective of time or whatever, they should take all the precaution and they should use the sanitizer or some cleaning technique so that surface can be cleaned easily. The second important thing is how much time the virus will remain active on the given surface is also depends on the nature of the surface. Because it has been shown that in some metallic surfaces it can live for longer as compared to others. So that is also one important finding. But as a general person or a layman, we should think that whenever we suspect that this surface can be contaminated, or suppose somebody is sitting on a table and he keep on coughing, then it's always better to clean that surface. So I think that is important. And along with that, we should never forget the hand hygiene, frequent hand washing with the soap water, and if soap water is not available, then alcohol-based rubs. If we keep all these things in mind, then certainly we can cut down the transmission of this virus.
Okay. All right. Dr. Rai, if you can also shed some light on what is the treatment right now that is being done for people who have been detected with coronavirus, because like we know right now, there's of course no cure. The treatment is being done symptomatically. And there are people who have also recovered. So if you can just shed some light on that entire part of this whole thing.
Recently, the norms has been laid down. Until unless the two tests are not negative, we are not giving a clean sheet to the person.
Okay.
Second thing is, if the person has suffered from the coronavirus, it is not that dangerous. One should quarantine himself, should contain in the room only, and only symptomatic treatment is being given. And the best thing is always keep your throat wet. Keep on taking the lukewarm water, which will help you too much. Hydration should be maintained nicely, and a stable sattvic bhojan. Nice food, homely food, cooked food should be taken. And as far as possible, you should take complete rest. And by this we can, because at present, we don't have any specific medicine given to the positive patient. A number of things has come from the from abroad also, from our ICMR also. They are using some of the medicine which are being used for the HIV and others. But again, I will say there is no proper medicine. There is no vaccine at present. The only treatment being given is symptomatic. Until unless you don't land in the pneumonia, you don't have the respiratory distress, then only hospitalization, ICU, and ventilator is to be applied. Otherwise, again, I will say, keep yourself in the house, abstain from the crowded places, hand washing, keep on there. By this, you can keep yourself healthy and you can keep your other surroundings also healthy.
Okay. Indira Behara, just, you know, on that point, the fact that there is no cure, there is no vaccine right now, it is still a while away. But where are we right now with actually trying to find a cure? You know, of course, we're looking at this from a global perspective because all countries are working to try and find something that will help, you know, combat this. Where are we right now?
I think as, you know, was previously said, a lot of treatment for the less severe cases has been symptomatic. But for the more severe cases, countries have been experimenting with different antiretrovirals. The ICMR itself has recommended has talked about using two in particular. There's been a study, I think, from China about the use of a monoclonal antibody that's used for the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis, having an impact on controlling systemic inflammation in patients. There are multiple countries trying to understand. There have been very few countries, India is one of them, that have been able to properly isolate the strain. They're still studying the strain. They do not understand all the details of how it's functioning. And, you know, this is in terms of health timelines, this is a very short timeline that everyone's been working on. So it depends. I think different people say we're between, you know, anywhere between 6 to 18 months away from a possible vaccine for this particular virus. But I think what's very important, and that's what's come out of this, has been that it shows us, the lesson that we learn is that it's important to invest in our R&D facilities, particularly when it comes to studying science, biology, virology, and to make sure that we continue to both publicly and privately.
Right.
Domestic funding for R&D for health technology is extremely important. And as well as, you know, making sure that we are a little more reliant on domestic products, for you must already know about the shortage of APIs that come from outside, right? So, you know, maybe the other guests might have more answers, but right now I think we're a while away from concrete answers from anybody, really.
Yes. All right. We've got a caller joining us on the phone line, Krishnamurthy, calling us from Vishakhapatnam. Hi, thanks for calling us. Go ahead. What's your question?
Thank you, madam. We have about 280 apartments in Vishakhapatnam. Daily 300 maids are all coming.
Okay.
I want to have a prevention. So how can I prevent, sanitize those people to come while coming inside? What is the risk exposure is there? All those things I want to know.
So if you can just repeat your question, I didn't catch the first part.
No, actually we have a 280 apartment gated community in Vishakhapatnam.
Okay.
So we are on the management side. I want to, how to control these such people to sanitize. What is the sanitizer I have to spray? All those things I want.
All right. Indira Behara, if I can come to you here, you know, essentially what he's saying is there's a gated community where there are 280 apartments. So obviously, there are a lot of people who come and go. What are the measures that actually can be taken for a community like this?
I think most importantly, sir, we all have to be just aware about making sure that people that we come in contact and we ourselves maintain good hand hygiene. So we must make sure that we all wash our hands well with soap and water for at least 20 seconds and really scrub into it. And particularly, you know, whenever we're handling things that other people might be handling, if, of course, there are people that, you know, we come in contact with who display signs of, you know, a cough or a cold or, you know, ill health in general. I think it's advisable to just be understanding and give them some time off. Most importantly, people should first and foremost speak to their doctor. There is no need at this point or at any point really to get panicky about the spread of this. It's common cold and common, you know, flu season. So it's important to speak to your doctors first and then, you know, seek their guidance on next steps. But just making sure that cough etiquette and hand hygiene is practiced.
All right. Dr. Rai, you know, coming to you... Yes, coming to you here, like Indira Behara pointed out, this is a season where there is, obviously, it's a flu season. People usually end up falling sick at this point in time. Is there any, you know, simple rules that one needs to follow to figure out whether or not you need to sort of either go into self-isolation because of certain symptoms or need to go for testing?
As far as this season is concerned, normal flu comes and goes. And the viral diseases are self-limiting. If you keep yourself healthy in the healthy atmosphere and keep yourself complete bed rest, you will recover within 3-4 days. So there is nothing to be panicky. Only the problem has started because of the high publicity about the coronavirus and a lot of news coming from abroad.
I'm so sorry to interrupt you, but we've got a health ministry briefing that's going on at the moment. Let's quickly cut across.
Yes, political and administrative level. Following consultation with public health experts, the Committee of Secretaries, chaired by Cabinet Secretary, has reviewed and discussed with respect to various measures in place and further needed for control of spread of COVID-19. Based on the recommendations of the Committee of Secretaries, the group of ministers had detailed deliberation on this subject in their 7th meeting today. After a detailed discussion, social distancing measures as a preventive strategy has been proposed for implementation. These interventions are proposed to be in force till 31st of March 2020. While the comprehensive advisory is under issue, the important measures include closure of all educational institutions, schools, universities, etc., gyms, museums, cultural and social centers, swimming pools and theaters. Students should be advised to stay at home, online education to be promoted. Non-essential travel should be avoided, buses, trains and aeroplanes to maximize social distancing in public transport besides ensuring regular and proper disinfection of surfaces. Encourage private sector organizations, employers to allow employees to work from home wherever feasible. Meetings as far as feasible shall be done through video conferences. Minimize or reschedule meetings involving large number of people unless necessary. Restaurants to ensure hand washing protocol and proper cleanliness of frequently touched surfaces. Ensure physical distancing, minimum 1 meter between tables. Encourage open air seating where practical with adequate distancing. Local authorities to have a dialogue with organizers of sporting events and competitions involving large gatherings, and they may be advised to postpone such events. Local authorities also to have a dialogue with opinion leaders and religious leaders to regulate mass gatherings and should ensure no overcrowding and at least 1 meter distance between people. Local authorities to also have meeting with traders associations and other stakeholders to regulate number of hours, exhibiting do's and don'ts, and a communication drive in marketplaces like Sabji Mandi, Anaj Mandi, bus depots, railway stations, post offices, etc., where essential services are provided. And most important, while all these measures are being advised, it is to ensure that community can remain informed consistently and constantly. I would like to highlight that these measures are a preventive step to contain COVID-19 in the country and will be temporary measures in force till 31st March 2020. Further, travel advisories have been tightened to prevent the spread of COVID-19 from high-risk areas, expanding compulsory quarantine for a minimum period of 14 days for passengers coming from transiting through UAE, Qatar, Oman and Kuwait. This will come into effect from 1200 GMT on 18th March 2020 at the port of first departure. travel of passengers from member countries of the European Union, the European Free Trade Association, Turkey, and the United Kingdom to India is prohibited with effect from 18th March 2020. No airline shall board a passenger from these nations to India with effect from 1200 GMT on 18th March 2020. The airlines shall enforce this at the port of initial departure. Both these instructions, as I cited above, are again temporary measures and shall be enforced till 31st March 2020 and will be reviewed subsequently. Further, to bring to your kind notice, the fourth batch of 53 evacuees of Iran have arrived today and are being quarantined at the army facility in Jaisalmer. All are reported to be asymptomatic as present and are in quarantine as per protocol. Four new cases, one each from Odisha, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh and Kerala, have been confirmed since the last update given to you. There are now a total of 114 confirmed cases in India as on today, including 13 cured and 2 reported deaths. Contact tracing activity of these positive cases has led to identification of more than 5,200 contacts, which are kept under surveillance. We require a whole of society and a whole of government approach to deal with COVID-19 disease. जैसे कि मैं कहना चाहूँगा कि हमें समस्त समाज और संपूर्ण सरकार इस मोड में काम करकर COVID-19 को कंट्रोल करना होगा. Government is taking preventive steps to limit the spread of the disease and look forward for cooperation of everyone in the society in managing the situation. Thank you.
Just wait a clip. We have yet to give the additional information from MHA. You want to give?
Good evening, friends. The central government had earlier decided to restrict the number of immigration checkposts through which, on the land borders, through which international passengers would pass. The number was restricted. And regarding Indo-Pak border also, I think the advisory has been issued, so you must have taken note of it. Since morning today, the traffic on Indo-Pak border has been stopped, international traffic, that is. And the second point is regarding the enablement of states. It was discussed earlier, of course, where the states can use the funds from the SDRF, State Response, State Disaster Response Fund, for particular items, like they can establish labs, they can establish testing centers, they can establish quarantine centers. All these expenses can be met from the SDRF also. This is over and above, of course, the funds that they already have under NHM and other funds, their own budgets also. Thank you.
From the Ministry of External Affairs, please.
Good evening, friends. Just to update you from what has happened yesterday, you all are aware, Prime Minister took an extraordinary initiative of holding a video conference with the leaders of the SAARC. The SAARC leaders responded positively to this proposal at a short notice, and this reflects the common concern to tackle this pandemic from spreading within the region. Prime Minister stressed that the low number of cases in the region should not make... Prime Minister stressed that the low number of cases in the region should not make people or the leaders complacent in tackling this disease from spreading, because nearly one-fifth of the humanity lives in this part of the world and the region is very deeply interconnected. He called for cooperation and common approach to tackle the spread of these coronavirus in the region. The leaders exchanged ideas and best practices and reiterated their commitment to develop common protocols for dealing with communicable diseases. The proposals that were discussed in the video conference yesterday will now be concretized soon in consultation with the concerned ministries and departments. And I would also like to bring to your attention the creation of the MEA COVID control room, which has now become operational 24/7, the details of which have been intimated to all of you. And the function of the control room is to respond to the concerns of all Indians within the country and also from abroad. So this will be operational 24/7, and our officers are there to tackle any issue that will come in course of time. Thank you.
Now we can take some questions. Number 9.
This is Anu from CNBC TV 18. First question is, can you repeat the countries where the flights will not operate, the passengers will not be taken? And also, can you shed some light on the kind of hygiene which is there in the quarantine facilities? Because there are a lot of tweets which say, and that with pictures, which say that the hygiene of the bathrooms, the hospitals, is not at per the basic standards.
So in terms of travel restrictions to the countries, it is European Union, European Free Trade Association, Turkey and United Kingdom of India, where the airlines will be requested not to board the passenger coming from these nations since 18th March. Further, compulsory quarantine we have advised for people coming from or transiting from UAE, Qatar, Oman and Kuwait. This also will be applicable since 18th March 2020. With respect to quarantine facilities, see, all states have been advised. We have also advised them what are the minimum prerequisites which need to be organized when it comes to taking care of the quarantine facilities, what type of measures have to be adopted. So we are constantly in touch with state and following it with them.
Yes, number 11.
Hi, Mr. Agarwal. Two things. One, have we reviewed our testing strategy? I mean, are we going to test more? And also another thing would be the do's and don'ts, or rather the protocol for disposing of dead bodies who are COVID affected. That has been a problem we have seen. I mean, day before yesterday, it was a huge problem. So is there something that the ministry is working on?
So as far as testing protocol is concerned, the technical committee had sat and they had already identified the places and time when the sample need to be taken. Based on those guidelines, only the sample should be taken. We do not want unnecessary panic to be created, unnecessary people to be tested. Parallelly, we have also initiated effort in terms of increasing the number of centers across the country. So this is a major thought process at our end. Second is with respect to the dead body, the required protocol has been finalized by the Joint Monitoring Mission, headed by the Director General of Health Services, and those details will be provided.
99.
सर 13 मार्च को पंजाब सरकार ने एक प्रेस नोट जारी किया था और कहा था कि 335 लोग जो कि बाहर से आए हैं उनको ट्रेस नहीं किया जा सका है, वो मिसिंग हैं। तो क्या उनके बारे में कुछ अपडेट है? और दूसरा सवाल ये, नागपुर समेत कई शहरों से खबरें आई हैं कि वहाँ पे जो लोग पॉजिटिव पाए गए हैं, जिन पे जो कि ऐसी कंट्रीज से आए हैं वो हॉस्पिटल आए लेकिन फिर वो लोग वहाँ से भाग गए, तो क्या ऐसे जो मामले हैं उसको लेकर आप लोग क्या कर रहे हैं? और दूसरा, जो मिसिंग है पंजाब में उनको लेकर कोई अपडेट?
देखिए, जहाँ तक मुझे मालूम है, मैंने सेक्रेटरी हेल्थ का जो फीडबैक लिया था कि उनका ऐसा कोई उनका कोई नोट नहीं है कि कोई लोग भाग गए हैं। हाउएवर, एक चीज़ हमें समझनी होगी कि जब हम कॉन्टैक्ट ट्रेसिंग करते हैं तो कई बार हमारे को जो पेशेंट होता है उससे उतना सपोर्ट नहीं मिलता, और वो धीरे धीरे सपोर्ट मिलता है तो हम एडिशनल कॉन्टैक्ट बढ़ाते चले जाते हैं। साथ ही जब हम एडिक्वेट पब्लिसिटी करते हैं फील्ड लेवल पर, तब पीपल भी वॉलंटियर करते हैं। I will give you an example, एक केस का, कि जिसमें हमने पेशेंट से बात की, उन्होंने हमें काफ़ी कॉन्टैक्ट जिनसे वो टच में आए थे बताया, लेकिन एक पर्टिकुलर पार्टी जिसको उन्होंने अटेंड किया वो भूल गए। फिर उसके बाद हमने उसको भी लोकेट किया और उनको हमने कॉन्टैक्ट ट्रेसिंग में ले आए। तो इट इज़ ए कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस वेयर वी वर्क विद पेशेंट कंसर्न एंड एंश्योर दैट नो वन गेट्स मिस्ड आउट।
Now we move to 154.
स्वास्थ्य एवं परिवार कल्याण मंत्रालय जो है वो चार राज्य, महाराष्ट्र, गुजरात, उत्तर प्रदेश और सिक्किम के लिए कोई विशेष आदेश जारी किया है कि जहाँ स्कूल कॉलेज सब बंद किए जाएं?
आपने बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन पूछा, ये सब फेक न्यूज़ है। हमें आपका कोऑपरेशन चाहिए कि ताकि इस टाइप की फेक न्यूज़ से जो भ्रांतियाँ समाज में फैलती हैं, लोग कन्फ्यूज होते हैं, जो पैनिक क्रिएट होता है, उससे हम बच सकें।
33।
लव अग्रवाल जी, आपसे सवाल है, क्या कम्युनिटी टेस्टिंग शुरू हो गई है? अगर हो गई है तो कितने लोगों को टेस्ट किया गया है? दूसरा सवाल ये है कि लोग जो विदेश से आ रहे हैं वो ट्रेवल करते इधर उधर घूम रहे हैं, कई सारे कंप्लेन आ रहे हैं, तो उनको कैसे आप एक तरह से रोकेंगे कि घर में क्वारंटाइन रहें?
देखिए, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया है कि टेस्टिंग जो होती है वो प्रोटोकॉल के हिसाब से होना चाहिए। हम सिस्टम में अननेसेसरी पैनिक नहीं चाहते। हम चाहते हैं कि जो पर्सन है जिसकी या तो हिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्रैवल है या जिसके कॉन्टैक्ट की ऐसे ट्रैवल की हिस्ट्री से कोई है, लिंक है, और उसको कोई सिम्टम्स है उसको ही हम टेस्ट करें। हम लोग बिल्कुल नहीं चाहते कि लोग अननेसेसरी घबरा जाए, पैनिक में हम लोग एक्चुअल पेशेंट को मिस कर जाएं। तो दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट टू अंडरस्टैंड, वी हैव नॉट टू मिस ए पेशेंट एज फार एज पॉसिबल। उसके साथ ही जैसे आपने कहा है कि दूसरा प्रश्न आपका था, हाँ, दो जो हमें ब्यूरो ऑफ इमिग्रेशन से जो हमें डिटेल्स मिलती हैं उन डिटेल्स को लेकर हम अपने स्टेट सर्विलेंस ऑफिसर को, स्टेट सेक्रेटरी हेल्थ को भेजते हैं जिनके थ्रू उनको मॉनिटर किया जाता है। इसमें यह जरूर जो आपका पॉइंट है कि अगर कोई भी लोग हमारे पास ऐसे नॉलेज में आते हैं जिनको हम पूरा ट्रेस करते हैं, पूरा मॉनिटर करके उनके सिम्टम्स के हिसाब से उनको 28 दिन तक मॉनिटर कराया जाता है।
फ्रेंड्स, आज एक और मीटिंग है, इसकी वजह से हम सारे क्वेश्चन आपके नहीं ले पाएंगे। सो द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम 114, प्लीज, देयर इज अनदर मीटिंग एट 7 o'clock, वी विल कम बैक टू यू इफ रिक्वायर्ड। जस्ट
Mr. Agarwal, Pallav Bagla from New Frontiers in Science. You recommended social distancing. Now, you expect 1.3 billion people each to maintain a 1 meter distance from each other?
We suggested social distancing as one of the approach, one of the non-therapeutic approach to manage the situation. It is not that the social distancing alone will be the criteria to manage the situation. There are other interventions which are there. It is important to understand that it has historically been found not only in this pandemic, even otherwise, ki agar aap social distancing maintain karke rakhte hain, to aap usko, uske spread ko aur uske intensity ko kam kar sakte hain. So that is the effort of government.
Friends, if required, we will come back to you again. You see, there is a meeting at 7 o'clock. Please wait. Thank you very much. We have come only from one meeting, and after this briefing, we are going for another meeting. Please.
So that was a briefing from the Health Ministry on the kind of measures that are being implemented till when the restrictions will be in place, and essentially the way the travel restrictions have been tightened, what exactly is being done. All right, let's just cut back in. All right, slipping into a quick break, we'll continue on the other side. Stay tuned. Got breaking news that's coming in. A coronavirus positive patient who got himself admitted to a private hospital in Bhubaneswar came in contact with 129 others. That's what's being reported at this point in time. Now, the private clinic where he had visited has now been shut down. Those are the details coming in. This patient came in contact with 129 others, and the private clinic which he visited has now been shut down by the Odisha government. Meanwhile, the national capital has stepped up measures to fight the deadly virus. Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal today announced a series of precautionary steps to be taken in the national capital. With this, the gyms, theatres, nightclubs, spas, weekly markets, all of that will be closed until the 31st of March. Delhi government has also banned any gathering with more than 50 people, which excludes weddings. However, the Chief Minister has requested people to postpone wedding events as well. No decision has been taken on malls as yet, but the Chief Minister said that malls will be disinfected daily and people would only be allowed entry after cleaning their hands with sanitizers.
अभी तक हम ऑलरेडी स्कूल्स, कॉलेजेस, आंगनवाड़ीज और स्विमिंग पूल्स को 31 मार्च तक बंद करने के ऑर्डर दे चुके हैं। आज ये निर्णय लिया गया कि जिम, नाइट क्लब्स, स्पाज, इनको भी 31 मार्च तक बंद करने के ऑर्डर्स दिए जा रहे हैं। और दूसरी जो भी गैदरिंग्स हैं, अदर गैदरिंग्स, 50 से ज़्यादा गैदरिंग्स, चाहे रिलीजियस, सोशल, फैमिली, पॉलिटिकल, कल्चरल, ऐसे कोई भी गैदरिंग अलाउ नहीं की जाएगी 50 से ज़्यादा। अभी इसमें शादी को एक्सक्लूड किया गया है, लेकिन हमारी अपील है सबसे कि अगर हो सके तो शादी की डेट्स को पोस्टपोन कर दें।
Breaking news that's coming in. Civic polls in the state have been deferred in the light of coronavirus. We're talking about West Bengal, where civic polls have been deferred in light of the coronavirus outbreak. This is West Bengal, where civic polls have been deferred. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Nation Now. Stay tuned to Mirror Now. Newsroom Live comes up next.